Hi there, I hope you're doing well. This week I am painting the 3D printed mini Namur Makir from the Artisan Guild's October release Rakshaking Headhunters. He has been primed in German Panzer Grey and I'm starting off with Night Blue for his cloak. I'm going to be doing more 3D printed minis on the channel, so if there's any you want to see painted, let me know in the comments below. You could also let me know on Twitter or check out my Twitch streams. I stream Tuesdays, Thursdays and Sundays at 8 p.m. UK time. Always happy to chat, hang out, and if I own the file, I will happily print it up and paint it for you. With the cloak all finished, I started on cold grey for his robes. This does take several layers to get good coverage, as that's just how cold grey seems to work, because it starts off really dark and you have to go lighter by giving it more layers. Next up is his skin, well, more fur, but it's using lava orange, which also takes several layers to cover the primer, but that's fairly common for an orange as they do struggle to cover dark colours. I now moved on to the brain matter beige, and this is for the top part of his robes and the rim around the plate on his waist. With the robes now finished, I used Greedy Gold to do all the armor plates he has, along with the lamp around his waist and his bracelets. Next up is Charred Brown for the book and pouch on his waist, as well as the pipe and sword hilt, just to give it a bit of variation. The final metallic is shining silver, and this is for the sword and the details on the book, along with the chain sort of thing he's got across his chest. To finish off the base colours, I used royal purple to do base for the smoke coming out of his pipe. Now onto the highlights. I start off with ultramarine blue to do all of the raised areas on the cloak, leaving the night blue in those recesses, because I want the cloak to end up with quite a light colour, so we're going to work up towards that. The next highlight is the skin using Fire Lizard. This is probably as far as you should go with the skin, and this is as far as I will go if I ever print him again and paint him again. That is the perk of a 3D printer. If I don't like how it turns out, print another one, paint it. Don't have to go through the hassles of stripping a mini. I then used hex lichen to do the highlights on the smoke, making sure to leave the areas facing down the darker color. Next up is ash grey for the roads. This covers the majority of the cold grey, just leaving it in the shadows. I chose to cover most of the robe with this highlight, as cold grey does not play too well with dark wash tones. So it's heavy, it stains it heavily and just doesn't look as good as it normally would. I now use matte white to do the pages on the book and to highlight some of the brain matter beige. The highlight's not that noticeable when you first put it on, but it adds a bit of variation, which sort of makes it pop that bit more once the wash covers it. I then do the third color of the cloak using crystal blue, and this is just for the topmost areas and anything that is directly lit from above that the sunlight can easily get to. The final highlight for the smoke is oozing purple. The next color is matte black, and this is for the eyes and the base. I do go to do the toenails with this, but then decide almost immediately not to do that, as it wouldn't look too great. Now that the black is finished, I use bone white to do all of his nails. Well, or claws, being a rakshasa, but his claws, his teeth, and I do his nose in this color as well. For the last colour before the washes, I used sun yellow for his eyes. I then go on to do a third highlight for the fur, which I think turned out too bright overall, and would definitely not recommend doing that. If you're following this, and if I do it again, I won't do that. I now move on to the washi, starting off with blue tone for all of his cloak. Getting full coverage in this as I'm hoping to blend those three tones together. I'd also do the sword blade with this, just to give it that sort of polished steel look. The next wash is red tone for all of his fur and the gold. I find red tone works best with gold as it doesn't look so oily as it does if you do dark tone, and it highlights red almost. The final wash is dark tone for everything else on the mini except for the smoke, as that does not receive a wash in this. And that will be it for Namur. Hopefully the first of many 3D printed minis I do on this channel. As always, close up images of this guy will be on my Instagram. If you have any questions or requests, you can drop them in the comments below or check out my Twitter. If you want to chat and hang out while playing some games, check out my Twitch stream. I stream Tuesdays, Thursdays and Sundays 8 p.m. UK time. Like, subscribe if you enjoyed, but most importantly, don't forget to be kind to each other.